Listen carefully. Explain the process of biogas production. Commonly used model of biogas production is KBICRIARN. The digester used for biogas production is called as biogas plant. Cattle dung used as a raw material. Sometimes field yard manure also used as a raw material. Digester is partly buried into the soil. This digester is buried. This is soil level and this is buried, partly buried into the soil. Upper part only remains above the soil. Anaerobic digestion involves three stages. Actually, gobar gas or methane. Methane along with H2S or hydrogen gas is produced in the biogas. That is produced by which bacteria? Anaerobic bacteria. Because under the soil there is no oxygen. Packed digester is there. Therefore, methanogenic bacteria, anaerobic bacteria, Clostridium bacteria are grown into the digester and produce gases. Anaerobic digestion involves three stages. First stage, that is hydrolysis or solubilization. That means cattle dung is mixed with water and in equal proportion to make a slurry. And dung and water, that slurry is poured into the digester through the pipe. Okay? Then anaerobic hydrolytic bacteria, that is Clostridium and Pseudomonas, hydrolyze the carbohydrates into simple sugar, proteins into amino acid and lipids into fatty acid. That is digestion. First step is hydrolysis. Second step, that is acidogenesis. That is what anaerobic acidogenic bacteria convert simple organic material into acid like carbonic acid, acetic acid, H2 and CO2. Third step is methanogenesis. Methanogenic bacteria, that is methanococcus, convert acetate and hydrogen and CO2 into methane, CO2, H2O and other product. 12 molecules of CH2COOH converted into 12 molecules of methane, that is CH4, and 12 molecules of carbon dioxide. 4 molecules of carbonic acid, that is HCOOH, converted into methane plus 3 molecules of carbon dioxide and 2 molecules of H2. What are the benefits or importance of gobar gas? Most important question is asked, that is right, significance or importance or benefits of gobar gas as compared to the other gas. Natural gas is very costly. First, biogas is cheap, produced in very low resources or very minimum resources, therefore cheap. Renewable resource or renewable source of energy. That means produced again and again by using dung, slurry, dung and other urine and other material produced by the farm. Easily generated. There is no complicated process. Next, easily stored and transported. Next, used for cooking, lighting, street lighting and in industry also. And improve sanitation, because all the dung and along with other farmyard manure, we can produce gobar gas by collecting all these, by cleaning all these material. Gobar gas is eco-friendly gas. There is no pollution, therefore eco-friendly. Sludge used as a fertilizer. That means after digestion, here digestion takes place. This is dung and water slurry made into this pit, and then this is charred pit, and by in the digester, after some time, there is a production of gases, that is CO2, H2O and mainly methane. H2S gas also is produced. And all these gases are collected and finally connected towards the house as a through the pipe as a gobar gas. Or also used for lightning in the house or in street lighting or in major scale used in a industry. And digested slurry, then after some weeks or months, is collected as a sludge or biofertilizer or fertilizer. Very useful for crops. Crop yield get increased due to this fertilizer produced from the gobar gas or biogas. Okay, this is the biogas plant. biogas can be produced. These are some benefits of biogas or significance or importance of biogas. Okay.